Here now, Youngway Koo to get us started. And off we go from Glendale. Here comes Worthy to return. Oh, he's got room past the 30. And not much doing on this return. Good coverage. We're going to stop him in his tracks right at the 15-yard line. From the 35, it's first and 10.
Let's see what happens now.
On play action. Stroud.
Yeah.
Oh, they come after him right away, and definitely goes on the first play of the game.
If you're going to take a sack, you just can't add to it by taking such a massive loss on top of it. Understand when the pocket breaks down, move up, cut your losses. Now, not only do you lose that down, but now you face a big uphill battle if you want to extend this drive.
And that's going to be incomplete. Coverage was good that time. The contact jarring the ball loose and forcing third down.
Really just been a combination of errors here on this drive. I mean, the sack on first down put him in a bad spot. Then the incompletion there trying to gain it back on second. And now they find themselves in a critical third down here, or they're facing a three and out.
From the gun here on third down, it's Stroud. But it's the tight end, Brock Bowers. And he'll be brought down, but not
time
before they get this
shit together
all
now.
The way up near midfield.
I think it's the wrong one, but anyway.
Jones motioning here. On first and 10, here's Stroud. Quick throw, taken in. And they'll take this down.
Come on, baby.
Inside the 35.
They've done a nice job spreading the ball around. Make the defense have to account for as many different weapons as possible here early. I think back to our conversation with this coaching staff, Mike. They identified this guy as someone they needed to get involved early and often. So that might be his first target. I don't think it's...
Fuck.
That's over the middle and intercepted. Picked off by Divine Diablo. And the Cardinals are going to get it back here just past the 35.
So anytime a team suffers an early setback like that interception, human instinct says, Mike, we need to get away from our game plan. We need to adjust. I don't think that's the case. There's a lot of game left, a lot of chances to avenge that play and still connect downfield on some of these passes. All proven, though, Mike, they've got to identify what went wrong. Let's correct it so we're able to move forward.
Throwing right away is Allen. Pass complete there to Harrison.
The receiver thought he had a nice soft spot in that zone coverage, and he settles down to give a nice target to the quarterback. But the defense had eyes on him the entire time. Secure rally tackle.
Oh, they're on him in a flash, and he's lost the football. And it's recovered by one of his teammates.
Sometimes these games in the NFL, Mike, they get decided by simply how the ball bounces. I mean, how often do we see a quarterback in the pocket get stripped sack, and that ball ends up going the other direction? Fortunately for them, they can regroup, get back in the huddle, and live another day. Ball falls into the hands of his own guy, and he'll see if they can dodge this bullet.
That is knocked away downfield, incomplete. He made sure not to let the receiver get behind him. Third down stop sets up fourth down.
That was not there.
They told us this week they were going to try to come out fast, and tell you what, that's exactly what they did. Put immediate pressure on this secondary and let them know, hey, all game long today, you better defend every blade of grass because we're coming out firing. And even though that ball falls incomplete, it goes a long way in setting up the rest of this game plan as the game unfolds.
I wasn't down.
And he'll get forward a few yards on the return. And that's where
I get
the offense
better than that.
Will take over. So they come to the line for first down and 10.
There you go.
Jones motioning here. On first down, it's Stroud. Quick throw here is complete.
We are not going to go away from
and
that.
And he's brought down after a gain of six on first down.
trick when he waits if you get catch.
They'll work now on second and four. Jones motioning here. On second down, Stroud. Rush comes. They're setting up the screen. And it'll get him down after a gain of five.
Sorry, kidding me.
But that is enough for a first down. Hooper, the tight end, is in motion. Stroud to throw. He's going to keep it himself.
Yeah, thank you.
Avoids the contact as he slides to a stop after picking up the first down. A first down there on a gain of 12. From the gun, here's Stroud. A toss, left side, caught by his running back.
Everybody
and
on
he'll
the
be hauled down at about the 35-yard line.
That's already two catches for this guy. We haven't even seen him hand the ball to him yet. And that's really what these running backs have become in the league. They're really just all-round weapons. And if the ground game's not working, you can go to the air and vice versa. The more times this guy touches the ball, the better it is for this offense.
That's 13 more on that play. And quickly, another first down. So, not much to speak of in terms of scoring in that first quarter of play. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Greg and I back here in Glendale after this. A handoff as they try to run it here. And he'll manage to get this ahead for a pickup of five. They'll break the huddle. It's second and five. To the ground, he'll get it again. And the Dolphins are going to be set up with a first and goal. Nice run there. It gets them down to the six.
This is already a little better than the first time they had the ball, Mike. Remember, opening possession, three and out. Showing some signs of life here now. Nice pickup there by the back to pick up the first down.
Now a give, but here comes a reverse. What a move! He's in!
Yeah.
Touchdown, Dolphins!
No need to push it out. Just trying to get a point.
Now Justin Tucker for the point after. He's got it. And the Dolphins will take a 7-0 lead. Out there is Tucker, and he'll kick this one away after the touchdown was scored. And we'll see a return here from his own end zone.
Come on.
And he will get cut down short, shy of the 20-yard line. First and 10. Now Allen. Escaping the danger, throwing and completing. Here's second and three to go. Allen to throw. To the right side here. Pass is caught. And they'll bring him down, but not until he gets to the 38-yard line.
Every quarterback's dream is, can I get the ball out of my hand as fast as possible and get it to a guy that can do the rest after the catch? And it seems like nowadays, throughout the entire league, the best offenses thrive in yards after the catch.
Going for it all. And that one is caught. And he is out of bounds all the way down at the 30-yard line.
I mean, y'all serious about this shit?
Again, it's Allen to the air. This is intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons.
Y'all serious about that shit? Yes, now.
Here's Stroud. And he kept that play alive as long as he could, but the rush eventually gets to him and takes him down.
Just a great individual effort, and when you have a guy that can win his one-on-one matchups, now it becomes less about who's blocking him and how do we block him. Expect the offense to make some adjustments, because right now, one-on-one, this defender is going to win every time.
He'll go left side here and complete this one. Now a third and two. Now, Stroud. That's going to be intercepted.
Picked off. First time he was in that play. Stop that play.
And he is going to score. A pick six for the touchdown. Younghoe Koo now for the extra point. It's up and through. And the Cardinals will level things out at seven apiece. So back to level after the touchdown in time for the kickoff. This one taken at the seven. He'll get this up to the 28-yard line. Nice place for the drive to start. Unbalanced look here to the right side on first and 10. Hooper, the tight end, is in motion. Stroud to throw here on first down. He'll check this down to the running back. After the catch, he gets that forward for a gain of 9. A good spot here, second and a yard. Handoff here, up the middle, and he's going to be brought down up past the 45. Boy, some bulk in the formation on that right side here for first and 10. Now, Stroud. And he's not going to get too far, tackled after a gain of just a yard. Now the Dolphins going to use the first of their timeouts. Clock says 25 seconds till halftime.
Really well done here by the defense, Mike, executing this zone defense, and they've got to be able to pattern read. You're not just going to drop back to a spot and just play like a robot. Based on what the receivers do off the line, the defenders have different rules of where their zones move to. Well, they had that one dialed in right from the jump, and they were able to stop that play really before it got started. Zone route running, Mike, is very simple, right? I mean, everyone wants to complicate offensive football and make it super technical. Once you come off the line of scrimmage after the ball is snapped and you know it's zone coverage, as long as it's sort of in the area the quarterback expects you to be, my rule was just run where they're not, and when he throws it, catch it.
Out is Justin Tucker to try the field goal. Now the Rams going to use the first of their timeouts. Here's second and six. Opening carry of the game for the versatile Christian McCaffrey. Now whistles. Timeout. 3 seconds left in this first half. So now Mike McDaniel will send out the field goal unit. Officially an even 50-yard attempt.
Fucking mess of it.
This one off the upright. He had the distance.
Listen, I need to get a fucking field goal to get up.
And the score remains tied at 7. Coach, thank you. Back here on EA Sports as we count down to the kickoff of the second half. A touchdown apiece, 7-7 the score as we begin half number two. Here comes the return from a yard or two deep. And he'll be out of bounds just past the 25. The break the huddle coming up now for first and 10. They'll run with McCaffrey to start this drive. And they'll bring him down, but not until he gets to the 38-yard line. Throwing now, Allen here on first down. Off he goes. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield. On first and 10, it's Allen. He's got Parham, his tight end. And they'll get about 4 here as he is taken down.
It's not the big play they were hoping for, but first down efficiency, staying ahead of the chains, is what every offense is trying to find, and it brings up a manageable second down.
From the gun, Josh Allen. Gonna tuck it and go.
Nothing open here downfield. I think it's a good job just getting to the edge, getting something positive, getting out of bounds.
Here's a third down and 4. From the gun, it's Allen. He'll take a shot here for the end zone. That one is batted away, incomplete. No separation that time. Tightly defended. It brings up fourth down.
Nothing scarier for a quarterback, Mike, than to seeing that ball popped up in the air. It feels like that ball is in the air for an eternity, and all you hope is that it just harmlessly falls to the ground, and fortunately for the offense, that's exactly what it did. So this offense, they think this is a prime opportunity to go for it through the air on fourth down, but this defense was having none of it. Nowhere for the quarterback to go with the ball, no easy completions, and this defense forces a huge stop on fourth down.
Down the sideline, inside the 25. And they are not.
That's what I'm talking about, MC Gate.
He's in. Christian McCaffrey. Touchdown, Miami. Good-looking rushing touchdown there. Offensive line does its job. That back taking off to the end zone for the touchdown.
Mike, you're exactly right. He might get credit in the box score for that long rushing touchdown, but it was the big guys up front who were able to make that play possible.
Maybe that'll have to be something that might kick off. Tucking in for me.
Out there is Tucker, and he'll kick this one away after the touchdown was scored. This one is fielded in the end zone, but he decides not to bring it out. So they'll take over at the 30-yard line. A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. From the shotgun, it's Allen. And he'll just get rid of this. Smart play to throw it away. And that'll set up second down.
think the biggest issue and why they find themselves trailing in this game, Mike, has really just been the ups and downs of this passing game. At sometimes, he's highly accurate and efficient. But at others, he just misses too many easy throws. Question is, are they going to be able to overcome this quarterback inconsistency and pull this game out?
A dime.
Boy, that's a good play.
Incredible.
That's a big play. I'll tell you that. That's a dime. There's nothing else to say about that.
They'll throw on first down with Allen. Taking off.
He tried to buy all the time he could, but when he saw that space, he quickly turned from thrower to runner, and he's able to pick up a nice gain on first down.
Second and a yard. Out of the gun, here's Allen. He's gonna look for the home run ball. And this will be incomplete.
I can tell you from firsthand experience, Mike, that is a lonely and long jog back to the huddle. I mean, you're an inch away from being the hero with a deep touchdown. Instead, you let it go through your fingertips, and you got to come back to the huddle.
That is going to
be pulled in. He's got it. Marvin Harris Jr. Touchdown,
I
mean,
I
Arizona.
Think I could do that one.
So they take the shot downfield, and it is caught in the end zone for a touchdown. What a big play that is, Greg.
Absolutely, Mike. And the key to a play like this is when the ball travels this far in the air, they teach you, don't look back, look up, because that's where the ball will be. And in this case, he was able to secure it and come away with a big touchdown.
Here comes Worthy to return. And he'll work this one past the 25 to right about the 28-yard line. Jones motioning here. Stroud to throw here on first and 10. They'll try to set up the screen to McCaffrey. It'll be taken down rather swiftly after a gain of just 3.
Just a little slow developing on that screen play there. It was pretty obvious to the entire defense exactly what was going on. Nobody was thinking pass. Nobody was getting back into their drops, and just nowhere for that back to go.
Thrown left side. The catch is made. Field empties. 5 receivers in the formation for third down and 5. From the shotgun, C.J. Stroud. That's caught by McCaffrey. He is knocked down hard. Wow, they stomped him in his tracks, but he does have enough to pick up the first down.
Really nice job here by the quarterback, understanding what did he need to pick up a fresh set of downs. In this case, that underneath drag route was all it took. Get the ball into the hands of your receiver, pick up a first down.
So,
I don't know what's going on.
Now in the books. This is Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Here's first and 10. They'll run, and nothing on that one. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it.
Coming off that edge, Mike, you have to quickly determine, is this a pass or is it a run? And once he realized it was a run, he's able to shed his blocker, make the play, no gain.
They'll keep it on the ground. He'll get about 3, and that's going to lead to third down. Big play coming up. This is third down. To throw, it's Stroud. He'll throw it left and has his running back. And he'll try to get to the marker, but he's going to wind up a yard or two short. Now or never, they'll throw on fourth down. And that's going to be incomplete. They had to take that chance, trailing here in the fourth, but they will turn it over on down.
Sorry, but didn't get it.
On first down, it's Allen. And they're going to track him down. He couldn't find the receiver, and down he goes.
Really nice start for this defense here early through the first quarter. Two different players each recording a sack. Offensive line's going to have to get together on the sideline with their coach and identify where's the weakness in our protection, how can we get extra bodies and extra attention, because we still got a long way to go in this one.
Well, they'll get some of the sack yardage back, but it's still going to leave them with third down. So, 2 minutes to play here in the second half. Greg and I back for the conclusion in a moment. What can they do here on third down and seven? They'll drop to throw. He manages to get the throw away and completes it.
That gotta be a sick
inside
joke.
The 20-yard line.
Him to get that deal. I mean, mine. Great deal. That's gotta be a sick joke.
They're trying to burn some clock here as they keep it on the ground.
Ain't that good.
A gain of four as he's taken down. Allen will throw. And the rush gets there. Down he goes. Now the Dolphins going to use the first of their timeouts. And they'll stop it with 28 seconds to go in the game.
If there's one positive remaining, it's the fact that they're still in scoring position. But with the way they've been able to move the ball down here in the red zone, they're thinking six, but after that last sack, their chances of converting here for a touchdown have gotten a lot more difficult.
Now Miami going to use the second of their timeouts, and they stop it with 22 ticks left on the clock here in the fourth.
Well, it goes without saying. You want to play wide receiver in the NFL, Mike. How well can you change directions? How fast can you get your body from one direction to another? And when you can cut like this guy, I'm not sure how you guard it.
This one incomplete. The defense up to the challenge there. They force the incompletion, and they'll take the ball over on downs. They'll come up for first and 10. Jones motioning here. On first down, it's Stroud. That is caught down the field. It's Worthy. Out of bounds inside the 30. It's a big play when they needed it the most. That goes for 58.
They really showed off their connection on that pitch and catch, Mike, and just really good ball placement and really good separation downfield. And when those two things align, it's just really challenging for a defender to stay with them and take that play away.
So out comes a guy who's been here before. Big spot for Justin Tucker. Win the game. So, a big one coming for their veteran kicker. This one, he's gotta have.
All right. Nice stand, bro.
Clear, sunny skies. We are ready for football. And off we go from Wembley. He'll take this at the 10. He stopped on the return at the 27.
I'll do better than that.
Let's get this show on the road. It is first and 10. First play is to the air. That's taken in nicely by Brock Bowers. And he'll get it out to the 34 before he's tracked down.
He's just one of those guys, Kate. Even when he's not open, he's still a target thanks to that physicality and his ability to just play bully ball. They don't like forcing into coverage, but sometimes when you got a bully like him that can create space, you just find a way to get him the ball.
Second and 3. Oh, he put some heat on this deep. That's complete inside the 35-yard line. And he will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Rams take a 6-0 lead right away. Well, Brock, they could prove me wrong, but I don't think touchdowns are going to come that easily the rest of this game. But starting out, we all welcome the quick score.
Yeah, not a lot of energy exerted, right? Not a lot of their cards shown just yet. They only got a couple plays into their strategy. And they found
Pedro's
mystery still to come with what they're going to do schematically. A lot of answers have to be found defensively.
So following the missed point after, a chance to take his frustrations out on that football as he sends this away. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. They're out and set, first and 10. Burrow out of the shotgun. His first throw is an interception. Pat Surtain has it. And the Rams get the football on the first turnover of the contest. Already in an early hole on the scoreboard. That is not what they needed in response, Brock. Give it away possession with the pick.
You know, we got a lot of game left, obviously. Nowhere close to them putting it away. But you can see things starting to unravel a little bit, even after just two possessions. A touchdown here could really continue that momentum towards an early runaway.
Out of the gun. They'll give it to him inside. And he's brought down for a loss.
I know from the position of the quarterback, Kate, sometimes you hand that ball, you put it in the belly of the running back, and you send him right into the teeth of a buzzsaw. You can feel it from the jump, and that call from the defense, well, it came at the perfect time.
A give left side to Jones. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
This coordinator tried to show some trust and belief in his offense. A run after a negative run? Well, you lose a lot of equity and belief in that coordinator. I don't think he's going to try a third run after back-to-back negative losses.
This drive in some serious trouble. It's third and 12. To the air, Stroud. They'll set up the screen. He has room past the 25. And he's brought down at the 17-yard line. It's a gain of 17 on that one. And it brings up an L.A. first down. Motioning one of the tight ends. Working inside the red zone. And he will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Rams pick it off and get points on the ensuing drive. Brock Bowers the touchdown.
Well, we all know that he's somebody they like to have working down near the end zone, Brock, and there is so many ways they know how to use him down there.
Yeah, things are constantly different down there when you're trying to defend him, which is what makes defending him so tough, borderline impossible at times. He can make the smallest little tweaks to his route just like a receiver would. It's a totally different animal, a nightmare for these defenses.
Now, probably still mentally kicking himself after that missed point after. He can take a little frustration out here as he kicks this away. That's going to be taken in at the 8. And this drive will start inside the 25. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He's looking to throw. On the move, headed right. And he protects himself with a slide there after a decent gain.
You know, Kate, back in the day, we had a slip and slide to practice for moments just like that. Actually practicing how to slide and get out of harm's way. Nice gain on the play. And denied that defense yet another chance to take a shot at him.
And he maybe got back to the line there, but no further. No gain on 2nd down, and they need 2 here on 3rd. It's a design boot. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free. Incomplete. Hit arrived as the ball did to break things up. So it's going to be 4th and short.
See the pass, time up your hit, and jar that ball loose. Not a lot of players are hanging on through a well-placed hit like that one.
Defense coming off that incompletion needs one more stop here on 4th. They'll run for this. And he's tackled with the 1st down yardage. That big 4th down call is how we close out.
All right.
I'm one, ready?
Welcome back. We'll begin this 2nd quarter with the Giants in possession. They'll try to attack this deficit starting with 1st and 10. And he's into the front for a gain of about 2. Offense in the hurry up here. Play action now. Burrow. He had it for a moment, but a great defensive play to jar it loose. Incomplete. His first target doesn't lead to his first catch. So they're left facing 3rd and long.
As a defense, you got to see the pass. You got to time up your hit, and you got to jar that ball loose. Not a lot of offensive players are hanging on to that one through a well-placed hit.
They'll run it here on 3rd down. And he'll be brought down a step or two shy of midfield. They're going to mark him at the 48. That play gains 6. It's going to be 4th and 2. Trying for it with Burrow. He connects downfield on 4. And he will score. Touchdown, New York. The Giants start to fight back with their first points of this game. I love plays like this, Brock. Sometimes you just got to ask your dude, show me what you got, man. Show off those wheels, and he did just that.
Yeah, beauty in simplicity, right?
Yep.
Now, when you run that fly route, you got to win right from the jump.
Uh-huh.
And you got to protect yourself from the sideline, too. Don't get pushed to the boundary. Give your quarterback room to throw it up. You can find Pater.
So here's the kickoff, Brock. Just 6 points now separating our teams. Starting at the 10. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. They'll get this drive started. 1st and 10. From the gun, Stroud. That one finds Xavier Worthy.
And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. So the big play moves him well past midfield, has him set up now at the 35. Here's Stroud on first and 10. Throw came out right as the defense got to him. That's an incomplete pass.
Well, that's one you chalk up to the pressure earning that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target.
Yeah, they got him.
Altered that last second attempt to get rid of it.
Second and 10, Stroud to throw. Jones reels it in. And they stop him.
Really?
He's marked down along that 18-yard line.
He's going through the play.
16 yards on the play. And the Rams are going to have a first down.
Good offenses. Okay, good play callers know how to utilize their personnel. They know where they wanted him. They wanted him in a route in space where he could make that initial play comfortably, but then go to work after it.
Out of the shotgun, they'll give it to him inside. And the plunge up the gut yields nothing there. No gain there that time, and it's second and 10.
Made it all look so simple, didn't he? That linebacker sorting right through the traffic, finding the runner. That's instincts come to life.
Give him 6 yards on the run, so it's going to be third and 5.
That's a run that you'll take the result in the NFL every time. A nice play, a solid game, but it's also a run that you know, and you may come back to, because if you were that close to breaking off an explosive one, you really break the backs of a defense.
Stroud now on third. Completed here to McCaffrey. And he will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Rams grow their lead just before halftime. Christian McCaffrey, the touchdown. Three drives, three touchdowns. It has been wash, rinse, repeat for them offensively, Brock. As well, we all wait for this defense to find a little backbone before this becomes a runaway.
Yeah, I'm a little torn up here in this booth because you're exactly right. Offensively, this is just machine, surgical. Defensively, you're running the risk of being embarrassed here pretty quickly.
So following the missed point after, a chance to take his frustrations out on that football as he sends this away. And that one bounces through the end zone for a touchback. First and 10 now from the 30. Here we go. Out of the shotgun, Burrow. Chased out to his right. Complete over the middle to the big tight end. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. The Giants using their first timeout. They'll have two left to work with before halftime. Big play gets him across midfield, sets him up first and 10 from the 40. Burrow from the gun. And he finds a seam down the middle, complete. Timeout called, and that's going to be the second for New York. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. They'll keep this drive moving and come to the line for first and 10. From the red zone now. And he will score. It's a New York touchdown.
Oh, fucking three all fucking day on this standard.
All right, partner, what do you think? Was that a design read, or did he just see space and he was reacting more on the old quarterback instinct there?
Yes. I think yes on both of them. And that play happens so fast that it really is instincts on both sides.
That one splits the uprights, and they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. So here's the kickoff, Brock. Just 6 points now separating our teams. Return starts from the 16. Has a hole left, room to run.
I would say that's not.
At the 20.
I can't believe he fucking get
and
that.
He will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles.
That's a lucky play, though.
The Rams will add to their lead at the end of the half. It's a Roma Dunze touchdown. Well, when it's set up perfectly, Brock, and you get an exciting return man back there fielding it, wow, there are not many plays in football more exciting than taking a kick back for six.
Find those blockers, follow those blockers, and then step on the gas. So simple for me to describe, yet so tough to execute on the field.
And he'll probably still mentally kicking himself after that missed point after. He can take a little frustration out here as he kicks this away. And the return sets them up just beyond their own 20.
All right. Oh, so you didn't watch it. Think about it.
Probably looking at our final snap of the half here on first down.
James on your free guard.
Back to throw it. The Rams get to him, and he's dropped. So we're through two quarters now, still a half of football to be played. We'll be back with more of the NFL on EA Sports. Back from the break, I'm Kate Scott, joined by Brock Heward, and we are just moments away from the beginning of our second half. Two quarters to go
James.
Has this at the
didn't
six.
Get the free guard tonight. The free safety.
And he gave it his best to get to the 25, just a step or two short of it. He's out along the 24-yard line. And the drive will start out with a first and 10. Now Burrow. Forced out to his right. Got to him right as he threw it, and it falls to the ground. Looking for his wide receiver there. So that brings up second down.
Hey, Mr. Quarterback, that's a throw that's going to go somewhere else. Double coverage was waiting for him. Think an interception to be had. And completion is still pretty good for the defense.
The give here on second. Oh, he gets clobbered behind the line. Working quickly here. Third and long. Here's Burrow. Sideline. He's got it. And he gets the feet down, too. What a play on third and 13. And this drive will indeed continue. Throwing is Burrow. He'll dump this one off to his running back, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not until he reaches that 45-yard line. First and 10 now. Here's Burrow. Uh-oh, he's in trouble, and the Rams bring him down. And the big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
And look at that. All that effort and success from the previous play, it is gone. Credit to this defense who snapped and cleared. That's part of this game. You got to snap and clear. Give up a big play, come back and make a big one for yourself. And they do get home at that side.
And this is marked down right along that 40-yard line.
When you see play action, do all you can to get your eyes to the tight end, because that's their bread and butter. That play action gives him time off the line, helps chip a rusher, or even helps sell that fake. And then when he releases, he gets out.
The Rams get to him, and he's dropped. And the defense jumps through to back him up ahead of fourth down.
That sure ended up being a worst-case scenario. Pass just kept coming and coming and bearing down. And he was looking for an escape that wasn't there. It's one of those plays in hindsight, Kate, where you really got to understand, I got to cut bait, cut my losses, and avoid such a negative play.
Escapes the pocket. incomplete. I'm not sure that was an advisable gamble in this spot.
Well, he tried.
I've been here from the start. A little snap bag, homie, with a plug in his heart. Took these Billy Strong cards and now they rip me apart. Now they run around in circles like them kids in the park. Not afraid of the dark, there ain't no monster inside. I pray to Jesus Christ, homie, they just keep me alive.
Justin Tucker has this all teed up. And off we go from Wembley. He's going to return it from a yard or two deep. And he's brought down just inside the 25 on the return. So their offense out now to get this game started. It's first and 10. Looking to throw right away. And that catch is made down the right sideline. Great effort there.
That's a great thought.
He'll move the sticks after ripping off a gain of 28.
You know what I like about that, Kate? I like that they're not coming out slow. They're willing to go with some looks here that will yield big yardage down the field instead of just settling for dinking and dunking the ball.
On first down, Allen. Like a good target, Brock. Neighbors is there. And they're going to haul him down a step before the 30, right at the 31. A 19-yard pickup, and that's going to move the chains.
You want to become a quarterback's best friend, do that. Turn a short little gain, a short little pass into some yards after catch, and that quarterback will find you again.
Now Allen off the play action. Too much lead on that throw. That falls incomplete ahead of his target.
Can't cover it much better than that really well-covered gain on that play. There just simply was not a window for him to sneak that throw in.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Again, Allen to the air. This ball's cut by McCaffrey. And he'll get it down to the 24-yard line.
Rhythm. You hear me talk about rhythm a lot. Whether it's a golf swing, a baseball swing, heck, even a bowler gets himself into rhythm. And I'm just telling you, Kate, from experience, these little throws to running backs, it's one of the best things to get your offense into rhythm and a nice little gain on top of it.
Space to the left. And he's going to have this all the way down to the 4. They get 19, and now they're going to have first and goal.
That right there, that will make the coaches happy. He didn't just get the first down, but got a healthy chunk of bonus yards afterwards.
Left, left, left. Working inside the red zone. Escapes out to the left. And he's brought down real close to that goal line at the one.
It's one thing to draw all these routes up when you're in the pocket. It's quite another when a play breaks down. Timing on routes change when you leave the pocket and scramble. What a great adjustment to still deliver a clean ball.
The fullback's got it. Look at the power. And the defense waiting for him at the line, and he goes down. Offense up to the line fast. Third and goal for Allen. Getting out to his left. And this will be a Las Vegas touchdown. The Raiders finish up an excellent opening series. Christian McCaffrey, the touchdown. Kicking unit comes out for the extra point. And this kick is through as they take a 7-0 lead.
Oh, boy.
Out to kick it away. Here's Pinion. Return coming here from the 12. Breaks the tackle, still going. The ball is loose. Oh, but the fumble goes out of bounds. Ooh, close call there.
You know, those defensive guys, they will tell you that the sideline's their best friend, right? A lot of these routes are trying to push the receivers and move the real estate. Well, sometimes the sidelines could be an offensive player's best friend when that ball bounces harmlessly out of bounds.
First down, Stroud. And the Raiders get there and take him down. And the big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
That is not a good omen at all. You spent so much time, Kate, on the first 15 plays, and that first play, you've rehearsed it in your head over and over as a quarterback, as an offensive line. You never, ever want to go backwards, have such a negative play, but now you got to flush it and quickly move on.
And it looks great flying through the air, Brock, but problems on the business end as it falls to the ground. Third down coming up. To the air, Stroud. That one is incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact.
Get the fuck in,
Brock. Got his first look of the game, so that brings up fourth and long. The Rams are set to punt. He sends this away, and oh, this is going to be a field flipper. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. It's a 61-yard punt that time. And it'll be Raider football. Offense ready to begin this drive. First and 10. From the shotgun, it's Allen. Flush down now to his left. Oh, he was on the move, but so was the defense, and they take him down. So before they can set up for another play, we've hit the end of the first quarter. Neither side separating much so far. More Madden Ultimate Team action coming up on EA Sports. Time now for the second quarter. Raiders in possession. They have second and pretty long here. Trying again following the sack. He puts some juice on a deep throw down the middle. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free. Incomplete. First time this game they've looked to him. And that's going to leave him with a tough third and long.
Well, that was almost one of those nice chunk plays you like to see in the NFL, Kate, before he was able to recover and provide the hit and ultimately dislodge the football. You like to see that physical edge and scrappiness to contest any kind of shot plays down the field.
Third and long, it's Allen. Uh-oh, he's in trouble, and the Rams bring him down. And they're going to have to regroup after this one.
Awareness. That's what I call it, Kate. Awareness. You got to have a game awareness and understand the situation. Third and long, you should never take a sack. Put the ball in play or throw it away, but don't take a sack in that situation.
They are going for it. Allen. He throws a bullet deep to... He's got it. Complete. And he does quite a bit of damage before they finally take him down.
You know, Kay, we often talk about flipping the field in special teams, right? A kick return, a good punt. Well, an explosive play like that does the exact same thing. Look at the difference in field position. By hitting on that shot, you've totally flipped the field and the tone of this drive.
Oh, he gets clobbered behind the line. The rookie out of Alabama there on the tackle. We've hit the two-minute warning now in Britain. The Raiders pushing for a bigger lead before halftime. Back to the line they go. It's second down. Operating from the gun, it's Allen. Rolling left, buying some time. An all-around tough play for him. He took a shot on the release, and it definitely affected the throw. It's incomplete.
That is a DB's best friend's pressure. That pressure earned that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target and hit him to alter that last-second attempt to get rid of it.
Buys time, rolling right. He had it for a moment, but a complete defensive play. Jar it loose, incomplete. Looking for Malik Nabers that time. And that brings up fourth and long.
Timing is everything in life, and timing is everything defensively. That throw was just a little bit late and gave the defense time to close, deliver a pop, and knock that ball loose.
It's a run on fourth down. And he'll go down here at the 16. And a surprising fourth down call doesn't yield a first. We've got a turnover on downs. Now it's Stroud. Has the connection to Jones. And he gets leveled just before he reaches the marker, and that hit prevents a first down. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. Operating from the gun, it's Stroud. Fires over the middle, caught. And what a hit there. Ouch, she faced the press for moving the chains that time.
That's just great instincts. Go air it out on second down rather than just play conservative and run it. They hit a weak point in the coverage and don't need to worry about third down at all.
Here's Stroud on first and 10. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he's able to cross midfield before going out.
That's madness, bro.
That's what you call efficiency. Exactly what you're looking for in first down. Textbook. It sets up second and very manageable, and then creates that space if you want to take a shot downfield.
To the air yet again. It's Stroud. That one finds Xavier Worthy. And he's brought down after pushing to that 35-yard line. He picks up 15 on the play. And it brings up an L.A. first down. They're set up at the 35 now. Stroud throwing here on first. He's got Bowers working the sideline. And he's out a yard or two shy of the 15. They get 18 yards out of it and a new set of downs.
I love throwing on first down. And when you see a first down pass just like that, it's taking advantage of a matchup you plan for, and you go out and execute.
On play action, here's Stroud. He's on the move. And he's just going to get rid of this one. Smart move there. When you saw the field, it's going to be second down.
He did exactly what he was supposed to do on that play. Felt the pressure and escapes the pocket. After that, it's on somebody downfield to get open and give him a target. No one did. And he simply has to get rid of it.
Second and 10, Stroud to throw. Able to find Jones. On the turf, the ball's out, he lost it. And it looks like the offense was there to recover it. They're inside the five.
When is Madden? Madden need to kill someone. There's a bunch of shit.
They'll have two left to work with before halftime.
I can't even lie.
This offense in position now. It's first and goal.
Really cool animation.
Back to throw, Stroud. And he will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles. The Rams earn the chance to tie before halftime. Xavier Worthy, the touchdown. Well, he definitely wanted to get that one out quick, Brock. They did just that, and it ends in six.
We hear it all the time, but it is so true, Kate. This is a game about matchups. And when you see a throw that quick, it really was determined pre-snap. It was great design and tremendous execution.
That one right down the middle. And we're all knotted up. Deep, this is going to come out. Only manages to get this back to the 20 before he's taken down. They've got first down here, but just 18 seconds to work with. First play, they go quick out to the left, complete. And this one does not go far. They'll come to the line here, second and nine. Working from the gun, it's Allen. On the move, headed right. That is caught downfield on the right side. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down.
I may love watching a great thrower, but I love watching a well-done route too, Kate. Make that guy think you're trying to stack him only to drop your hips and cut right inside. Some good work to help reset those chains.
Throwing for the end zone. And this will be a Las Vegas touchdown. The Raiders take a lead on the final play of the half.
Oh, for fuck's sake, I forget.
Exactly the play they were looking for, Brock. They saw it, and he put it right on the money.
Yeah, it really was a perfect play. This is what it looked like in practice, but more importantly now, to get it done in game time, that's what you're looking for. Amazing when it all comes together.
Setting up to try the point after. And the extra point is up, and it is good. So that's the halfway point of this edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Brock and I will be back right after this. Well, that first half, certainly an interesting one. Kate Scott, Brock Heward with you as we get back and see what the second half has in store for us. Two quarters to go from London Town, and here we go in our second half. Return coming from the six. He's got a lane up past the 30. It's an excellent return, but he gets popped at the end of it.
Well, that's exactly the way you want to come out of the locker room to begin the second half. And really, Kate, this third phase of the game, the special teams, you just see the boost and the energy they can give to their team when they deliver a nice return to start this second half.
Shotgun now for Stroud. Well, the pressure nearly got to him, but still a good play defensively as that one falls incomplete.
Mm-hmm. This is why we hear about closing speed so often when you evaluate players. You know, once he senses the pressure, he's getting rid of that ball. It takes a player who can close quickly to get to him before it's released and alter that throw.
Stroud to throw again on second. Throw wheeled in by Higbee. What a hit! He gets flattened to the ground.
Quarterbacks will look for their tight end short in just about any situation. They take away the deeper options. Well, there's their consistent source of positive yardage, the trusty tight end.
Stroud now on third. Complete beyond the marker. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
You know, they call that the money down for a reason, because you're just simply not going to last long in the NFL if you don't convert a good portion of your third downs. It's the money down. And nice to see them roll the dice and continue the series.
From the 44-yard line now, first and 10. From the gun, Stroud. No hesitation, and that one's caught. And this is through the midfield stripe and onto the Raiders' side of the field.
It's not just imperative that a quarterback knows man or zone. Same thing for a receiver, especially on a drag route. When he sees zone coverage like that, just settle down, find the soft spot, and give your quarterback a chance.
After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. Stroud off the play fake. Made the throw as he was getting hit, Brock, and it's incomplete.
You need to buy your receivers enough time to get open along the route, and your quarterback enough time to find and hit them with the throw. When the line doesn't hold up, incompletions follow.
And that's a win for the pass rush. Hit as he threw it, leads to the incompletion. Fourth down coming up.
You know, when we were growing up in the backyard, we call them alligators. One alligator, two alligator, three alligator. He needed another alligator in order to get that ball off. Credit the defense for forcing the incompletion.
Offense still staying out after the incompletion. They're going to try on fourth. Looking to throw. Hit at the end of that play. Oh, baby. But he hangs on through it. Still able to get that first down. Throwing now off play action. To the sideline and brought in by Worthy. It's a gain of 22. And the Rams are going to have a first down.
That is what elite offenses are all about. Why worry about three downs when you need only one? Move the chains in one play and keep driving that defense backwards.
And he will score. Touchdown, Los Angeles.
I tell you, bro.
The Rams cut into the lead coming out of halftime. Brock Bowers, the touchdown. Tucker on for the extra point. That one splits the uprights, and we're all tied up. Now Tucker on to handle the kickoff. Return starts from the goal line.
Hey, okay.
And this return is brought to a halt just across the 10. They're out and set, first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Allen. Connection made with his running back down the middle. Into the red zone. And this will be a Las Vegas touchdown.
Okay.
The Raiders grab the lead on their first series of the half. Christian McCaffrey, the touchdown. His second scoring catch of the game. Kicking team out to try the extra point. And he sends the point after right through the uprights. To kick it away, here's Pinion. He fields it from the 8. And he's walloped just as he gets across the 25. What a hit! He's down shy of the 30. drive starts out with a first and 10.
Here we go.
Here's Stroud. And the Raiders get there and take him down. And the big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
I'm not sure that deficit's going anywhere anytime soon. If anything, this is a defense that sees their offense creating not a ton of separation on the board, knowing they've got to shoulder the load. And sacks like that go a long ways towards doing it.
After the sack, another pass on second down. That one falls incomplete and brings us to the end of this third quarter. A touchdown aside in that frame as we run out of time in the third quarter. It's Rams football. They trail late, but this game's still very much in reach. So after that prior incompletion, we've got third down. Looking to throw. Finds his man. It's Worthy. And this one's brought to a halt at about the 36-yard line.
You can earn your money in the NFL in all sorts of different ways, but defensively, in a league where you're just not hitting as much in training camp, you're not tackling as much as they got to in the old days, when you can make a play in the open field, keep them short like that, I promise you, some money will follow.
Desperation time on fourth down.
Ah, for fuck's sake,
it's
going
to be incomplete. Couldn't connect to extend the drive. And they don't get a desperately needed first down. They're going to still trail after they turn it over on downs.
And they go wide open, bro. What?
You know, kid, I don't think I've ever been a defender that cares. All they want to do is get off the field. Doesn't matter if it's a drop pass, deflection, breakup, even an interception. Challenged by the offense to get one more stop to get off the field, and that's exactly what they did.
No progress on first down, and that'll bring up second and 10.
These linebackers of today, they are so quick. They're so twitchy. You don't get a body on them in a hurry, they're going to stick you right at the line of scrimmage.
We've reached the two-minute warning from London. Raiders feeling lucky with a seven-point lead. Second and 10, need to get some positive yardage here. They stick with McCaffrey. And he gets absolutely popped to end that one.
Let's say got milk.
Keeping that pace going as the clock continues to run. He's back to throw. Chased out to his right. Taking a big shot. He makes the catch. And now he's going to head out of bounds after a nice game. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal.
Not there again.
The analytics are pretty clear. It's hard to move the ball in this league with short little dinks and dunks. You've got to get the explosive chunk. You've got to get the big play. And that throw to the outside, that gets the job done.
Hurry up offense now as time runs down. Oh, look at this. He's setting up to throw. And this will be a Las Vegas touchdown. The Raiders go up by two scores, 13 points in the fourth. So that should be the one that does it, Brock. A big one late that puts him up here two scores.
What a complete performance overall. The clock where it is and where it stands right now, Kate, that should be the capper. And that is so satisfying as an offense to go up two scores.
That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead.
Mm-hmm. 2 points.
To kick it away. Here's
7 seconds.
That's going to be taken in at the 8. He's got a lane up past the 30. It's an excellent return, but he gets popped at the end of it. Good field position for the Rams as they get ready. First and 10. Now to throw. A bit of desperation on this deep shot. And that was probably their last gasp. It's intercepted.
Derwin
James picks it. And the Raiders will take over along the midfield stripe after the interception and return. Wait,
from the next place I'm going. Okay. Oh, now you can do it like that.
First and 10, ball set up at the 48. Trying an inside give now with McCaffrey. What a hit! He gets flattened to the ground.
They gave him a touchdown.
Manages just a yard on first down. That's going to be second and 9.
So broken.
You know, not a ton of yards, but still showing that commitment
nigga,
to the
nigga
ground.
Was in bucket. Nigga, that's right.
Instead, Greg, it is a fumble lost on the opening kickoff.
It's just absolutely the most disastrous beginning of a game you could possibly dream up. And what you do now, Mike, is not only does the other team get the ball, you send your defense out there early in this game and force them to have to defend a short field right away.
Here's second and 2. They'll go again with Williams. And it doesn't appear that he got to that first down marker. They'll only give him a yard, so it'll set up third down. They'll try to run for it with Williams. It's a gain of 10 yards. Good for a Patriots first down.
Oh boy.
Each week coming into the game, every team in the league, Mike, places a huge emphasis on their opening drive.
The ball,
but the key to that is sustaining possession, converting on third down. It's exactly what they were able to do here, keeping the ball on the ground.
Ball down to the 16-yard line, and it's first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. To the end zone there, but it is incomplete.
They let a golden opportunity slip away on that one. That's the matchup that they wanted. They just couldn't quite capitalize on it.
They'll try again here. Second and 10. Working out of the gun, it's Cousins. That's to the end zone, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Stephon Diggs there, and it's going to be third down. Cousins. Pressure gets there, and down he goes. What a call on this opening drive.
So you want to
go for it on fourth down. This is caught. He's got a long way to go.
Well, Mike, it's pretty clear early in this game the message they want to send is
like
we are going to be aggressive on offense. And that's exactly what they did there, going for it on
early.
But it's the defense that comes through and forces the turnover on downs.
First throw of the game is
I don't even go with madness. That's even worse madness.
And he is going to bring this one back.
This game,
a DB's dream, a pick six for touchdown. Daniel Carlson on to attempt the extra point. The kick is good, and the Patriots will take a 7-0 lead. Here's Carlson now. He'll kick this one off, following the touchdown on the other end.
This is madness, bro.
Gonna return this from the 10. Nice job on the return. He's down close to the 35-yard line. Set to go now on first and 10.
Great.
Gun here, Stroud. This one is caught by Bayless Jones Jr. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield.
This is clinic tape for any young wide receiver out there watching this guy run routes. He has the defender thinking everything is a go ball. Attack him vertically, and then when you get to your route depth, you stick that foot in the ground, you break in, balls on time, results in a nice first down pickup.
It's a gain of 16, and it's two nice plays to begin this drive.
Well, let's give some credit to the big boys up front in the trenches. They knew that blitz was coming. They held up just long enough that the quarterback could get that ball out safely and results in a completion.
And that one shut down pretty quickly. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Nothing more.
You could just see the frustration on the running back's face as he's getting helped up off the ground. Like, there was just nowhere to go from the moment he was handed the ball. Give credit to the defense. Great job.
We'll try again. It's second and 10. From the shotgun, C.J. Stroud. That's going to be incomplete. And it'll leave just enough time for one final play in this opening quarter.
Really nice job there by the defense defending the middle of the field. That is the most valuable real estate on the field. They know every single offense is trying to attack the defense between the hashes. So give credit. They took away all the throwing lanes, and that ball falls incomplete.
Jones motioning here. From the gun here on third down, it's Stroud. That's over the middle and intercepted.
Wow,
and the Patriots are going to have the ball at their own 18-yard line. We are through one. The Patriots out on top. And we're back to Foxborough in a moment. First down, Cousins. And a good effort there defensively. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Let's make no mistake about it, Mike. I mean, this passing game, it just has not been very efficient here in the first half. I mean, they've produced more yards on the ground than through the air, and incompletions like that certainly aren't going to help.
Cousins now on second down. He'll let this one go. Deep for Thomas. And he will take this one in.
All right.
82 yards. Touchdown, New England.
That's like four possessions to dig you. It's time for this shit. So.
The kick is good. And the Pats move out on top.
Come on,
14 to nothing.
And then he threw the ball. He gets the ball. He with a defensive lineman running by. And he jumped 10 story fucking high to get that one.
The touchdown on the other end.
Like, what's going on here?
Here comes Worthy to return.
Like, what's going on here?
Midfield. Look at him go! And he's gonna take this all the way back. 92 yards. Touchdown, Seattle. You talk about a response after the offense goes down the field and gets a touchdown. The special teams unit comes back to get the six right back for the other side.
And I've been there, Mike. You find yourself on offense. You watch your opponent go down and get a touchdown. And you're saying amongst each other, you're saying, hey, we're going to get the ball back. Let's go get one of our own. But in this case, the return unit says, no, no. Offense, you stay on the sideline. We got this. And they go back and get a score of their own.
From the six, here comes a return. He's across the 20, taken down just shy of the 25. So here's a first and 10 now. They'll start from the 24. Throwing now, Cousins. That's caught downfield by Diggs. A great connection there. They're gonna bring it down inside the 35-yard line.
Those are the explosive pass plays that this team is going to continue to mine all day. And you can see pre-snap, the quarterback loved his matchup. He allowed his receiver to work downfield. Perfect throw, and now sets them up to try to see if they can finish this drive off with some points.
Too much time. Too much idle time.
2 minutes to go here till halftime. We're back to Foxborough after this. So they come to the line for first down and 10. Here's Cousins throwing from the... Oh, no chance to get rid of that one. Under a heavy rush, he goes down.
Well, that's certainly one way to bounce back here defensively after giving up a huge explosive play on the previous snap. To bounce back and come away with the sack. Now you find yourself in second and long. You can catch your breath, and the opportunity to get off the field has just gone up.
Open man is Johnson. He's got him. They'll get maybe three out of that one, and it's going to set up third down.
This is one of those throws where you're hoping you do most of the damage after the catch, but give credit to the defense. Once that ball was caught, they were on him quickly, and there was nowhere for him to go after the catch.
He's got his man. It's Diggs. What a letdown for the defense. They allow a conversion on 3rd and 16.
So far here early, Mike, the key for this offense has been their ability to maintain possession by converting on these third downs. It's going to be a big storyline the rest of the way. This defense has to find a way. When they force third down, they got to get off the field.
And that one knocked away. It's incomplete. Brian Thomas, the intended receiver.
No comment.
And it'll be second down.
Nice job there by the defender. He's able to break up the pass, but I think if he's able to get there just a little bit sooner, now you can get two hands on the ball and give yourself a chance to come down with an even bigger play and come away with the pick.
That'll be caught by the running back, Williams. Well, he's brought down. That pass is going to pick up 4 and bring up 3rd down.
Defensive coordinators preach all the time, play pass defense with vision. It's exactly the case here. They're able to rally to the ball, keep that to a short game.
Cousins out of the gun on 3rd down. Nowhere to go. He's going to be taken down. Now Seattle going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. The field goal unit on the sideline. They'll line up to go for it on 4th down. Now, Cousins. And that is
that's
not
crazy,
gonna work.
That's
incomplete.
Just...
and they turn it over on deck.
And here we have a real gutsy call here, Mike, early in this game offensively. I think you're giving up a surefire field goal attempt, but at the same time, you're demonstrating to your players, hey, offense, I have a lot of trust in you, and let's see if they have this same approach as the rest of this game plays on.
And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be 2nd down.
So as halftime looms, Mike, they have to find a way to capitalize on this drive right here and make sure they end the half with some sort of points. Now, that incompletion, not ideal, but at the very least, it stops the clock. Catch your breath, get back in the huddle, and this next play, it's got to be a gotta-have-it best play call.
That's caught. It's Xavier Worthy. First time these two have connected this afternoon. And it'll wind up being a 1st down.
Seemed like the receiver, Mike, ran through like 5 different open zones, but once he found the one that he liked, where the quarterback was expecting him, you see him do a nice job throttling down, secures the catch, and he's able to pick up a nice game.
From the 34 now, it's 1st and 10. Looked like trouble getting the play in, and they're not even going to get to the line. They'll go play action with Stroud. And for the 3rd time in this 1st half, he's been intercepted.
That's crazy, man. Sick. Madness.
They'll come up here 1st and 10. Cousins to throw. Here's a screen set up to Williams. That's a nice pickup on a 1st down throw. It's a gain of 8.
Williams, go.
Now the Patriots going to use their 1st timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in the opening half. 2nd down, Cousins. He'll let this one go deep for Thomas.
We've already seen these two guys connect for a touchdown in this game, and had they been on the same page there, I think they would have been able to add to that total. Unfortunately for them, just a little bit off, and it falls incomplete.
The backfield empty here for 3rd and 2. To throw is Cousins. A ball deep for the end zone. That is caught. What a throw. Brian Thomas.
Wow.
Touchdown, Patriots. second touchdown of the afternoon. Now Carlson to add the extra point. He knocks it through.
Oh, Lord.
And the Patriots will take a 21-7 lead. The clock showing 5 seconds remaining in this half as the kicks away. And this ball is not going to get to the 20, so that's whistled dead, and the ball gets placed at the 40-yard line.
Okay.
They'll come up first and 10 at the 40. On play action, Stroud. He's going to air this one out for Jones. That's going to be incomplete. They took a shot on the final play. Prayer not answered. And that is how this first half will come to an end. All right, Coach, thank you very much. We welcome you back. It is quarter number 3. Third quarter set to commence. And we're back underway here on EA Sports.
Set up for this shit.
Cousins now to throw on first down. And open downfield, it's Johnson. And they are not going to catch up to him. He will score. 70 yards. Touchdown, New England. Carlson now for the extra point. He gets it to go, and the Pats will extend this third quarter lead. Here's Carlson now. He'll kick this one off, following the touchdown on the other end. Here comes Worthy to return. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. Unbalanced look here to the right side on first and 10. Off the play fake. Here's Stroud. Ah, the pressure, too much, and he goes down.
When it starts bad,
I just bothered with it, you know, getting worse.
I don't think that could be any more true than it is right now. They're already down by multiple possessions, and after that start to this drive with the sack, they find themselves once again in a massive hole.
Room to run past the 30. And he's taken down up past the 35.
This is like ridiculous.
Whatever they've talked about in the locker room at the halftime break seems to have worked. They've come out with a new established energy. You could see it when they took the field. Now this offense seems to be building on it, because with that chunk play, just a little bit of rhythm that they can build off of. They got a long way to go to get back into this game, but so far off to a good start.
Now, faking the give. He's going to air this one out for Jones. That ball broken up. It is incomplete. They tried the shot on first down, couldn't connect. It'll bring up second down.
We see this offense just continue to search for a spark. It's just this entire game, their execution's just been a little bit off. And now here in the second half, they find themselves down by multiple scores. They're going to have to connect on one or two of these big plays if they want to find themselves back in this one.
And he'll be out of bounds inside the 30-yard line. A big play for Seattle. 35 yards. First and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. That's to the sideline and pulled in by Harrison. It's a gain of 12 there. It's good for a Seahawks first down.
These crossing concepts are frequently used, Mike, throughout the entire game, all across the league. And what it does is it creates a lot of natural rubs. You run out the backside of the defense and rely heavily on the yards after the catch, and It's exactly how they're able to pick up this big game.
And the Seahawks are going to have a first and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Back to throw, Stroud. And he will win the race to the pylon. He's in. C.J. Stroud. Touchdown, Seahawks. Extra point try now for Tucker. His kick is good. And the Seahawks are able to edge a bit closer. Out there is Tucker, and he'll kick this one away after the touchdown was scored.
He capitalized on everything I do wrong. I mean, like, I was just...
And this one is fielded in the end zone.
On the will not line. Be returned. You see that wide receiver. You see the wide receiver wide open. Shoot that. I get to the break, but... Okay.
A first down throw for Cousins. Under pressure, and down he goes. They got him.
Defense came out in a soft zone, and I think it caught the quarterback a little off guard. He was trying to attack them downfield. By the time he was able to get through his progression to his check down, he ran out of time, and that's all the pass rush needed to get into the backfield and bring him down.
Now a second down throw for... Oh, they're on him in a flash, and he's lost the football. How about the defense getting to the quarterback, getting access to the ball, knocking it free, and coming up with the recovery?
I'd like to see the quarterback just be a little more secure with the ball, Mike. You can see he's just a little loose, especially when you're operating from the pocket. But give credit to the defender. Nice job attacking the ball, knocking it loose, and recovering it. And that is a big takeaway here by this defense.
Not much there. Maybe a yard. Here's a second and 9. Now a handoff. Oh, a wrinkle. Here comes a reverse. It'll be stacked up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. So both teams trade touchdowns in that frame as we get through the end of the third quarter. This is Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Third and 9.
What? Third and 9?
To throw is Stroud. Quick throw out wide. It's caught. The Seahawks are going to have a first and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They'll run here. And he will score. Game on. Touchdown, Seattle. Greg, they are pecking away at this one now. Very big touchdown. Gets them right within reach of pulling this comeback off.
Well, Mike, at the very least, they've given themselves a chance. But can they get a stop and get the ball back again for a chance to go down and really make this one interesting?
Point after now from Tucker. He's got it, and the Seahawks are back to within 7. It's 28-21. So, things a little more interesting now. Back to a one-score game as they kick it away.
Sleepy night.
This kick is fielded in the end zone,
huh?
But no move to bring it out. It's touchback, and that ball will come out to the 30-yard line.
Yeah, let me do it. I say rules.
The break the huddle coming up now for first and 10.
Got on easy.
And the drive begins with a run by Williams. And not much there. He's back to the original line. No gain on that one.
You want to see linebackers play downhill, Mike, meaning there's not a lot of side-to-side pursuit. They're attacking the line of scrimmage, attacking the ball carrier. That's exactly what we saw out of this guy here. He's able to make the stop at the line of scrimmage and keep it to no gain.
From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And he'll just bite the bullet and throw this one away. That was a good idea. Didn't force anything there. But now it's going to bring up third down.
So often, Mike, we see some of the biggest explosive plays in the passing game come from the quarterback extending the play outside of the pocket. Really nice job here by the coverage. They remain sticky on their receivers, nowhere to go with the ball, and all he's able to do is throw this one away. I know it fell for an incompletion, but pretty impressive. He was able to push that ball really far downfield as he was being hit. Really says a lot about the arm strength that this quarterback has.
The offense not coming off the field, and here's fourth down. Working out of the gun, it's Cousins. So just under 2 minutes here in this one. We'll come back and finish this one off after this. Here's first and 10. They'll drop to throw. That's caught. It's the tight end, Brock Bowers. And he's close to a first down. It's a gain of 9. Nice pitch and catch on first down.
As a route runner, once you identify zone coverage like they were playing here, the key is find open space and stay in it. He did a nice job here because that was not a big hole. Quarterback had to put a little extra on that one, and they were able to make the completion.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts left. It's first and 10. Jones motioning here. On first down, it's Stroud. Quick throw, taken in. Now, second and inches. 10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches. From the shotgun, C.J. Stroud.
I love this call, Mike. Second down and short. One of the best downs in football to take a shot. Give credit to the defense. They were ready for it. And a nice job by the quarterback, realizing there's nothing downfield. Take off, turn into a runner, pick up the first down.
Here we go, first and goal. Jones motioning here. Now Stroud. Rush comes, they're setting up the screen. And it's a touchdown! They have gotten to within one, and a two-point conversion can give them the lead here in the final minute. So they're not level yet. A critical extra point attempt to follow. The extra point is good. A big one as we are tied late in this football game. We are in the final minute of what is now a tie game. as we are set for the kickoff. Now, here comes a return from the 9. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. This is 1st and 10. Williams. And some space opens as he's brought down following a gain of 6. They'll come up now for 2nd down. On the ground, Williams. He is met and dropped. Good defense. Loss of a couple on that play.
This play here, Mike, is just all about the get off of the defensive line. Watch how fast they go when that ball is snapped. Nowhere for this running back except to go down for a loss.
Timeout, Seahawks. That is their 2nd. The clock will stop with an even 20 seconds to go. A lot riding on this play. Tie game. Final minute, 3rd down. Cousins gonna throw. That one on target to Williams. He's got it. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield.
It's 3rd down, and defensively you think you do a great job taking everybody away. But sometimes you just can't account for the quick little check down to the back and his ability to run in the open field and make people miss. He's able to pick up a huge gain.
That is incomplete, so the task gets more difficult. Time for maybe 2 plays. That's it.
There's a saying on defense, Mike, tips and overthrows, you've got to get those. Those got to turn into interceptions. So if you're the offense here, after you saw that ball batted in the air, man, I can promise you it felt like a lifetime waiting to see if it just falls harmlessly to the ground.
Cousins now on 2nd down. He'll get this over the middle to Diggs. And he's brought down, but they are out of timeouts.
You want to be a star in the NFL, Mike? These are the high-pressure moments that you can't shy away from. The greats, they embrace it. Tie ball game, 4th quarter. The game is on the line. Everyone in the stadium knows where that ball is going, and I can't blame them.
So big kick coming now for Daniel Carlson. This to win the game.
Shouldn't miss that.
This kick is good, and it's celebration time. A walk-off victory on the game's final play. So it's a win for the Patriots. They get themselves into field goal range for 1 final shot. Kicker delivers. They avoid overtime and come away with a 3-point victory. So that'll do it for us. For Greg Olson and our terrific team behind the scenes, I'm Mike Tirico. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. Follow us on X at EA Madden NFL. The Patriots winners at home, as we say so long from Foxborough.